standing in the 12th century cloisters in the monastery of San Pedro de Zaguias, which is now known as Senhora Do Convento. In the 12th century, the monks from Burgundy, Cistercian monks, came here and built this extraordinary facility. And as you look around, you see the sundial, which is still functioning. You see the oranges behind me, the roses beside me. And most importantly is this magnificent fountain that has been running with fresh water from the mountains since the 12th century. These spaces that are all around the fountain have been witnessing what has been going on here over those centuries. Extraordinary place. This is where the wine was originally made. The cellars down below is where I'm going to take you to show you how port is made in the Douro region here in Portugal. I'm in the cellar below the cloisters where the port is being aged. When we make port after the vinification, it's brought down here to age for 2 years, then the port wine submitted to the IVDP to get the Declaration of Vintage Port, which is the most sought after designation for port wine in the Douro Valley. We are now in the depths of the monastery in this magnificent underground cellar built by the Cistercian monks in the 12th century. It's got these incredibly thick stone walls that create a perfect environment for the aging of the bottled port. Once the port is declared to be a vintage port by the IVDP, it's then bottled and it is aged for 10, 20, 30 years either here in this perfect cellar or in your own wine cellar. It then is consumed and will truly express the terroir and the character of the Douro Valley. This is incredible. I'm looking at this magnificent mold that's growing here in this underground cellar, which creates perfect conditions for the aging of the port wine. What's even more magnificent is that there's this red mold on this stone, which I really have no understanding of why it's that color, but it is extraordinary to look at.